from Nero that is going to give him a chance to experiment with all kinds of new gameplay. There's going to be 8 different standard Devil Breakers that players are going to be able to use, and there's all kinds of different moves that you could do with the Devil Breakers that you couldn't do before in Devil May Cry 4.
Yeah, we're seeing some of that action here.
Look at that. There you go.
We're
jumping
also
right
seeing
in.
Tell us about this boss here.
All right. Yeah, well, it turns out, so this is the boss fight that everybody playing the Gamescom demo is getting a chance to play. This is the Goliath. Fun fact, the Goliath is based on our buddy Brian, who's the brand manager in Europe for Devil May Cry. At least that's what I'm telling people.
And he's huge.
He's huge, exactly. He's huge, and he's got a big booming voice just like this guy. So here we go. Already, we're starting with this, right? Itano-san.
Yeah.
Taking a look here. What's going on with the Goliath here? Look at this.
Oh, ここでね、切り替えて、
That's right. So this is exclusive to Inside Xbox right here. You see this? He just switched over to the Buster Arm, which is Nico's way of trying to replicate the Devilbringer. Boom!
Yeah,
I love
say,
the pose.
I was not able to do that.
He was doing that to us.
Yeah, absolutely. I got lost around.
You guys didn't have the chance to play as that because we don't have that in this build. That's an exclusive just for Inside Xbox to show you guys one of the special Devil Breakers that you can use in the game that we don't have the build today.
I've got to admit,
I'm a bit new to the franchise and I dabbled a bit in 4, but Devil May Cry 5 is going to be my first foray into it. I need to know the setup. What do I need to know about this game? Tell me a bit about the story.
Look, Devil May Cry is a game about Dante and Nero and the descendants of Sparta who are taking on demons, okay? So that's kind of the gist of it anyways. If you want to know how to get into Devil May Cry 5, I would suggest on Xbox Game Pass, you're going to get the chance to play Devil May Cry 4 Special Edition. So I'd say check that out, and that'll give you a nice warm-up for what you can play in Devil May Cry 5.
All right, sounds good.
All right, why don't we look at a little bit more gameplay, and Itsuno-san, perhaps you'll tell us what we're seeing here.
Sounds good.
Yeah, all right, so it's a little bit more of the Goliath here, I think, from the beginning, and we just saw a cool grapple move.
That's right. そうですね、ワイヤースマッチやりましたね。
ワイヤースマッチだと、よく見たら、EX アクトもね、結構使ってるんで。
そうですよね。So, you're right, there is this wire move that he's doing. This is actually an approximation of one of the moves you can do with the Devil Bringer in Devil May Cry 4. You can still do that in here, and whether you have a Devil Breaker or not, you can always do that move. You'll also notice, though, that there's this gauge in the top left corner that charges up. That's something called, you can do something called the EX Act. And that's a move that if you time your button press just right, you're going to rip up your sword right after doing an attack and strengthen your next attack.
So, I wish we had talked to you before we had played.
Yeah, before we played. I'll ask you this right now. There's melee. There's obviously the guns that you carry, and there's your Devil Breaker, right? What do I need to know going in? What's the best way to chain combos, get that best ranking?
The best way to chain combos is to do a whole bunch of different moves real quick here. But look at this. So
hit
here,
that
Nero's using the Gerbera Devil Breaker.
Yeah.
And you'll notice that he's got a supercharged move that you can do with that. And what he just did right there is called the Petal Ray. That's this move that bounces lasers off the walls. It's actually the most effective in small environments because every time it bounces, you're going to find that it actually gets stronger. So it was really smart of our guy, Yoshida-san, he's the one doing the gameplay here, to use that move in that environment. But to get back to your question, so Nero's got the Red Queen and the Blue Rose that he's had from Devil May Cry 4, so both melee attacks and gun attacks they can use at a distance, as well as these Devil Breakers, which are new to the series.
And there's a bit of a risk-reward, I feel like, with the Devil Breakers. Like, if you rely on them too much, you lose that arm, right?
Exactly, you're correct. What's going to happen is there's a couple different ways that they can break. You notice in the bottom right corner here that you actually have a limited number of Devil Breakers at any given time. And so if you take damage while you're using a Devil Breaker, they could break. Or if you do one of their super moves, then that could break it. Or then finally, there's another one called Breakaway.